I photodestined this little shielded box from Thales Defense Limited. So I am happy it is finally here, because sometimes receiving a parcel can be quite a challenge. And actually, the first attempt, the item was export restricted from the UK by Pitneybose. It was lost in a mail, and I was refunded, but the item got lost. And luckily enough, I found another one at the same price, or at around 5 British pounds. It was not export restricted, but it was dropped in the mailbox of my neighbor, which was away on vacation. It is finally here, luckily enough. So we have a small module, Thales Defense, 3 connectors, and this information. So NATO stock number. It is an electronics components assembly and a coil driver. So you might think something about column driver, so something about a display, but apparently not. I believe it might be radar, maybe phased array radar part or something like this, not sure. On the back, nothing except a modification record sticker and some kind of built-in heatsink with a metal plate over it. 3 connectors. This one from Microway, with very little contacts, and 2 coax connectors like such. So either this thing is new all stock or has been refurbished, but I believe it is new all stock, probably never installed. And apparently here, maybe serial number. And it is all. So really, really curious to see what we have inside. And you will notice we have Posidrive screws, which is not very common. So of course you need the matching screwdriver. So let's undo the screws. Okay, ready for a big reveal. Ta-da! Okay, in the cover nothing except machining traces and a layer of Kapton. So this is machined from a solid aluminium block, it seems. You can see the, it was milled apparently. So, we have apparently 2 layers of electronics, a circuit board here, connected with this flat flex to the connector, secured by a number of extra Posidrive screws, and here we have what seems to be high frequency circulators, and I can see, I can guess here at this level, apparently maybe ceramic circuits with golden tracks on it, on them. Okay, so I hope it will be possible to separate this board at least to gain access to the lower level. We have here something totally weird also. So first sticker, column strip line connector assembly. Seems to be some kind of a combiner, because obviously we have here 4 channels which got combined in one connector in one way or another. So first the electronics. So we have a connector, clinch here, bonded. A whole bunch of old school tantalum orange capacitors. This logo here, I believe it is the French Sagem company logo. Not totally sure. A bunch of fuse here and here. And we have the ICs. Alcatel here. Word model number. Atmel. Crystal oscillator. And here for chips by AMS, it seems. 0232SAH- and a lot of other numbers, so I will put in the video description the model number of the main chips and any link I find about them. And we can see here each time we have a fuse, so it looks like we have some power amplifiers or maybe transmission transmitters. And it will amplify something and need fuse. So these things seem to be high frequency combiners or circulators branded Mika with a model number you can see on this one. Really, really weird and unexpected. So I will try to undo now this layer of circuit board and we will see what happens. Okay, circuit board is out, and okay, I was quite surprised, but yes, now I understand. Here is the bottom side, and you can see we have a lot of golden pads making contacts to zebra strips in here, to these four modules. I hope it would be possible to see inside them, but maybe they are completely sealed. So here it is written Racal Defense Electronics Antenna Control Module. Okay, so as I said, something about an antenna and different brand here, Racal. Very, very beautiful gold. Contacts on here. So we continue. Where is this frame here apparently? So let's try to undo it and see what happens. Okay, the screws are off. Here, by the way, it is written 4.1 divider combiner assembly. So, will it come off this thing? Wow. Seems super mega delicate, but it is coming off a little bit at a time. Okay. The zebra strips are all coming loose or not. I will deal with them later. So obviously we have four times the same thing. Little modules, little bonding wires. This seems to be a single block, and I don't know if it is possible to open it or not. But here, yes, it seems super delicate, these things. There is some kind of a pad here over the module. It come off. No, it is tearing off, but it will not. Okay, all this for that. Sadly enough, this model number of part, electrostatic sensitive, but not really possible to dig any further with no additional damage, because you can see it is laser welded cover over this assembly. And one thing I will do, however, is to try to undo one of those covers. So I will reinstall it. Little bit missing here. I'll try to complete it as good as I can. Okay, not too bad actually. So let's undo one of those things here. I believe it is a connection to this part, which is and here we have yet another logo of Thomson CSF. Apparently serial number, so yes, we have four times hybrids, obviously, in ceramic. Okay. Yes, it is why it is not necessary to remove this part here, because it seems to be made from one single block pressed together, glued together. But you can see we have a gold strip, bonding strip, interconnecting the two things, so super delicate, and it is why it is not possible to extract the wall plate here, because it is actually bonded here. Okay, so a little bit sad I was not able to open these modules, because probably we have goodies inside. But it is what it is. If I find another of these assemblies at the same price, maybe in a bad condition, I will definitely take it in order to be able to tear it down completely and open one of the modules here. But for now, it is my only one, so I want to keep it in my collection. There is here this very annoying little thing which came loose. Wow. No wonder it is something super expensive and delicate. Look at this. Not even sure how to put it back together here. Like such. Wow. Really, really something special. And probably formerly mega expensive. So my best guess, it is something about radar or something like this. A phased array radar antenna controller, maybe. For one strip of sensors on the radar of antennas. Not sure. And, I did not find any information with the references number on Google, by the way. Nothing. Okay. So, yes, it will apparently drive four antennas in one way or another. So let me try to reinsert this annoying thing with all the zebra strips. Not too bad, except for one, of course, which is just completely missing. Where did it go? Ah, it is laying flat here. Okay. I will reinsert it from the top. Okay, like such. And now, wow. And you see how delicate this thing is, really. Okay. So, quite interesting. I wonder what is the purpose of those black pads. Probably just electrical insulation. Yes. So really, really nice golden tracks. Sadly enough, it is laser welded. And not possible to go any further. But really, really a beautiful piece of electronics. It is exactly the kind of things I want to collect and focus my collection on, but not always easy to find. And when you just have an eBay photo of a closed module, you cannot know what we will find inside. So it is always a little bit of a Russian roulette. Okay, so I will put this back together. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.